the most
automation calendar. Nope.
Through.
Is Zoho Marketing Automation confusing the hell out of you? Well, you're not alone. There's a ton of people out there who feel the same way. So make sure you tune into these tutorials to make sure that you get your system set up properly at the start. For today's tutorial, we're going to be talking about the Marketing Planner and how you can utilize it effectively for your team. So let's log in and I'll see you there.
All right, everyone, now that we're logged in, let's get started. So we're gonna go over to the planner section over here on the left-hand side, and I'm gonna show you the marketing planner. Now, you're probably not gonna be using this, but it's important to know that it's there in case you find a use case for it. Marketing automation has some integrations, but it doesn't have a lot of integrations. So we'll go through this and I'll show you why it's maybe not the most useful tool for some items, but it can be useful in other instances. So let's go ahead and let's start building a plan. This basically gives us a way to track our return on investment and increase traffic to our website. Maybe it's increased traffic to our social channels. Maybe it's passive conversion, which is something that you're trying to get people access to, whether it's a white paper or some sort of PDF that provides value, you're trying to convert that way. Or maybe it's about active conversion. So that campaign would allow you to track and see how and where your ROI is coming from on the different conversions of the products you have. It allows you to go back and run a marketing plan on that to see where your marketing spend should actually be. So let's go ahead and build a plan and dive right into it. So as I mentioned before, we have the traffic generation, we have the passive conversion, and then we have the active conversion. So take a moment, maybe pause the video, take a look at these, understand what they mean. But in this case, in most cases, I think you'll probably be wanting to focus on the traffic generation over here. So we're going to go ahead and create a traffic generation marketing plan. So now that we have clicked that, we need to put in a test traffic gen, and then we want to drive more traffic to our website. So we're good there, let's just click next. And now we have a bunch of options in here. So our objectives here are to specify a measurable objective of your campaign. And so our options are increase the number of website visitors, increase the number of followers on social media, or a custom objective which we can choose. So over here, we're just gonna specify the custom objective name and we can add an objective again over here and we can select another custom objective. We can have multiple objectives, but in this case, we just wanna increase the number of website visitors. So we're gonna go with that. Let's set the start time. I'm recording in October 2021, so I'm going to just set this to November 1st of 2021 and have it end on November 30th, 2021. And then we have a campaign budget that we need to set for each of these channels that we're going to be utilizing. So in this case, we want to focus on, let's say, let's get rid of TV ads. We don't need that. Let's get rid of print ads. Let's say we want to focus on email, social, and business email marketing. Now email, your spend here could be, let's select currency type first. And let's select US dollar and let's show other channels. So we do have other channels we can add in here, surveys or billboards or affiliate marketing or something else that we can add in. And we also have a custom over here we can add if you so chose. Now we're just going to get rid of that. We're going to focus on the email here. So we want to enter our email budget. Our email budget is going to be, let's say, $250. Let's just say that that's how much it costs some of our employees to actually create the emails and send them out. So that would be our cost associated with sending out emails. Then we have our social here. Maybe we're paying someone $500 a month to manage our social. So let's just say $500. And then business email marketing, maybe we've purchased a list and we're sending this out. We set up a drip campaign. So let's say that's $400. We're going to just click save and proceed. All in all, our investment is $1,150. So now we have new options over here where we can set up targets and we can set up campaigns based off of our digital channels that we're utilizing, which is really cool. So we can increase the number of website visitors. The one thing I would say that the marketing planner is lacking in Zoho Marketing Automation is access to different social channels. So I'll show you that now by creating a new campaign. So let's post a campaign. Our options here are Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, and LinkedIn. So as you can see, this isn't maybe as relevant to some of our social channels that we're currently utilizing. So you wouldn't be able to utilize it fully just because we're not being able to post to Instagram or TikTok or any of those other social channels that could provide a ton of value and provide more traffic to your website. So that's where the limiting factor I think is in this application. However, if you wanted to go through with it, this is something that you could definitely utilize and you could definitely utilize capitalize on the email side and the business email marketing side. And as you saw, all those custom options back there, we could use affiliate marketing. Maybe you're spending, you know, $500 on affiliate marketing per month, something like that, you can also utilize. So I think this is important to be able to know what it is in case it does fit your use case. And we can go ahead and start creating new campaigns, normal and advanced campaigns over here. For business email marketing, we want to set up a new campaign. So let's say that there are no pages available. So we want the landing page for which a tracking URL has to be generated. So Inc. is a source or custom. We can set up what the source is. So in this case, let's just say the source is Facebook. I don't know. Let's just put in something there. So we're going to generate a tracking URL, or even for example, we want to a webinar. Maybe we want to see people go to that page, or maybe our homepage to our website where we're driving traffic to that webpage using our business email marketing. So we're going to generate a tracking URL. We don't have any landing pages, so we'd have to go through Web Assistant to select and create those landing pages, which we can certainly do. I'll show you that in another tutorial. But essentially what we do is we select the generate tracking URL, we'd get a URL, and then we'd throw it onto that page. And so every time someone visits that page, this business email marketing will track that. So that's actually really cool because we know that specific business email campaign has worked to convert as many customers as are visiting that page. So that's how you would utilize the business email marketing. And then down here, we have the set of target, so we can increase the number of website visitors. Let's create the target. Again, we'd have to add in our page that we're looking for. Let's say it's the home page or whatever it is. We can set up the planner goals or Web Assistant goals over here. We have a few different goals that we can add in the Web Assistant, but on the planning side, we can set up a specific landing page or others, and or we can set up a ton of different options here. And so for the expected number of visits, we want to say that we want to get maybe 500 visits out of this marketing spend, or 1,000 or 10,000. We can set that to be whatever we want. So we just go ahead and save that once we have this landing page organized and set up, and then our target would be there. So it does have a lot of options in it. This is basically to be able to track your return on your investment by trying to set goals and track those goals to see where you come out with at the end of the trial period. So again, I hope that's been helpful. As always, please subscribe below to our channel. We want to make sure that everyone out there who needs to hear this content or watch this content is getting access to it, and make sure that you like and comment on all our videos. That really helps us get out there to as many other people who are looking for this information as well. So join our social channels like Instagram and Facebook as well. We're building a great community and we can't wait to have you there. Have a good one, and we'll talk to you next time. Bye for now.